वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. सो अगेन वेलकम टू द फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज क्लासेस. लास्ट क्लास वी हैव गॉन फॉर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ योर लीजिंग एंड देन वी हैव गॉन फॉर द एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ लीज फाइनेंसिंग फॉर बोथ द पार्टी, दैट इज लेसर एंड लेसी. ओके, टुडे वील सी सम टैक्स रिलेटेड एस्पेक्ट्स इन केस ऑफ लीज फाइनेंस. ओके, वी विल सी हियर जस्ट द जनरल वन एंड द बेसिक वंस. इन डिटेल्स वी आर नॉट गोइंग. ओके, सो जस्ट इन फॉर द बेसिक्स व्हाट यू हैव टू कीप रिमेंबर दैट विल डिस्कस इन रिलेशन टू द टैक्स एस्पेक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द लीज फाइनेंस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो फर्स्ट विल चेक द लेसर पार्ट. ओके, सो वॉट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टैक्स ट्रीटमेंट of your leased assets from the point of view of lesser. Okay, very first point to keep remember is lesser shall be eligible for depreciation on the asset. Okay, that is deduction of depreciation from taxable income. Fine, now always keep remember whoever is the taxpayer. Okay, whoever is the taxpayer, if he or she wants to claim depreciation, then he or she should own the asset. Okay, here lessor should own the asset, that is lessor should be legal as well as beneficial owner of that asset. Okay, legal owner, very easy, lessor has only purchased, lessor has only paid, so definitely all the papers, documents on the name of lessor, legal ownership, very easy. Now coming for the beneficial ownership. Okay, so in case of beneficial ownership, whatever is your leased asset, okay, whatever is the leased asset, as we know very well earlier also we have seen, okay, at the end of the lease period, the asset lessee has to return to the lessor. Okay, that is lessor is having the right of reversion of the asset at the end of lease period, and this proves that lessor is a beneficial owner of leased asset. Okay, then the other condition also we have for depreciation. Okay, taxpayer should be using the asset. Okay, what we have seen just now, taxpayer, whoever wants to claim the depreciation, should own the asset, that is in terms of legal also and beneficial ownership also. And the another in this addition is the taxpayer should be using the asset. Okay, and here taxpayer, that is your lessor, uses the asset in the business of leasing. Okay, in the business of leasing, so lessor is having the, or lessor is eligible for depreciation on the asset. Okay, lessor will have the benefit. Okay, another part, that is entire lease rent. I hope you remember. Okay, as under the lease contract, lessee get the rights to use the product from the lessor. Okay, under that lease contract, and for right to use that particular asset, lessee has to pay the lease rent to the lessor, and whatever lease rent lessor is going to receive, that lease rent amount is going to be taxed as income of lessor under the profit and gains of business and profession heading. Okay, so two things for your lesser. One is lesser can enjoy the depreciation claiming, and the another is on the lease rent taxed is applicable. Fine, and again I have just given you the point, that is important point, lease qualifying as true lease will entitle the lesser to claim the depreciation. So if the lessor wants to claim for depreciation, make sure that it should be qualified, the contract should be qualified as the lease, not as the hire purchase. Okay, so this is your lesser part. Now let's check lessee part. Okay, just now we have seen lessor is going to claim the depreciation. because lessor is the legal and the beneficial owner. So very simple, just opposite here, lessee is not going to claim any depreciation because lessee is not at all the owner. Okay, now let's say whatever paying the lease rent to the lessor, okay, that lease rent allowed as normal business expenditure. That lease rent will be allowed as normal business expenditure, and in this case you have to make sure that particular that lease rent is related only to the business purpose only. Okay, only to the business purpose, then only you can treat your lease rent as expense and you can have the tax benefit. Okay, so far let's see, very simple. Next, to check out sales tax. Okay, sales tax aspects related to the lease finance. Okay, so generally we have, as in the starting only I have told you, we'll just check the basic or the general aspects. Okay, so generally your lease agreement handled by one of the three ways. Okay, very first way is, in most of the state, lessor purchase the property with a resale certificate. Okay, lessor purchase the property with a resale certificate and collects the tax from the lessee whenever they are entering into the lease agreements and lease payments start. Okay, so in short, first case is what, lessor is going to purchase the property with the resale certificate and make the lessee to pay the tax. Okay, then second aspect is, in some states allow the lessor to choose how to handle the lease. Okay, some states give the freedom to the lessor. You can decide how you want to handle the lease. That is, you want to pay the tax when you are purchasing the property and not charging the tax to the lessee, or you want to purchase the property with resale certificate. That is your first case. Okay, resale certificate and then charging the tax to the lessee on the lease amount. Okay, that the third case is, in few states, okay, in few states lease is not taxable to the lessee. So when we are saying lease is not taxable to the lessee, that means the another one, only one party left, that is lessor, and lessor has to pay the tax when the property is purchased. Okay, so very quickly, all the three, very first your way is what, whenever the lessor is going to purchase the property, purchase with resale certificate and collect the tax from the lessee. Or the another aspect we had, lessor is having the freedom to go however you want to handle it. That means you are you want to pay the tax while purchasing, or you want to purchase with the resale certificate and making lessee to pay the tax. Or you have the another way is that, in some states what, lease is not taxable to the lessee. So no question. Okay, when a lease is not taxable to the lessee, at the end of the day only lessor has to pay the tax, and that also when he or she is going to purchase the property. So this is the aspect related to your sales tax. Okay, next we'll check. So important, mainly two types. We have seen 10 types of lease finance. Okay, where the very first two we have covered, the financial lease, which is also known as the capital lease, and then we have covered the operating lease, which is also known as the service lease. So for those two, I have just taken here some items. Okay, so whenever it is a your case of your capital lease, okay, whenever it is a case of your capital lease and items are leased with the intention to purchase it at the end of the lease for a nominal amount. Okay, that means while entering into the lease contract, you have given the option that at the end of the lease period, lessee can purchase the particular asset. Okay, so in this case, what happened? The true object of your transaction is sale. Okay, and in that case, tax will be due on capital lease when the sale will be made. So whenever sale will happen, tax will be applied. Okay, in case of your operating or service lease, as the item is leased with no intention to purchase at the end of the lease period, so tax typically, okay, I have written here also. So tax will be deducted on each lease payments. So whenever the lessor is going to receive the lease rent, or with each and every lease rent, tax will be applicable. Okay, so just keep remember, capital lease, if the intention is to sell, then the tax will be due on capital lease whenever the sale will made, will take place. And in case of your service lease, as the intention is not to purchase the asset at the end of the lease, so tax will be applicable or due on each lease payment. Fine. Now, just to check again, we have to keep remember difference between hire purchase and lease finance. I'm really sorry, in the heading I have forgot to write the lease finance. You can make correction here. Okay. So it's a difference between hire purchase and lease finance. Hire purchase, I believe in your second semester financial accounting you have studied. So I hope you will teach me. Okay. So we'll just go for the some basic difference between these two, which we can keep remember easily from the exam point of view. So very first is hire purchase case. What happened? Whoever has entered into the hire purchase finance, okay, hirer, that is your buyer, okay, when the hirer will do the last installment payment, he will become the owner of the asset. Okay, but in case of lease finance, what happened? Ownership always lies with the lessor. Okay, then again the next difference, hire purchase case, depreciation hirer can claim because hirer is the legal and beneficial owner. And in case of your lease finance, depreciation is claimed in the books of lessor, okay, not the user, the owner. Okay, thus you have to keep remember what, in case of your hire purchase, hirer is the owner also and the user also of that particular asset. Okay, then the next difference is whatever installment payment done by your hirer, that payment include your principal amount and the interest also for the time period, whatever time period you people have agreed, okay, for the utilization of your asset. But in case of lease finance, what we know, we used to have the payment in terms of lease rent. In hire purchase, payment in terms of installment, but in case of lease finance, payment in terms of lease rent. Okay, and which covers what? Cost of using an asset. Earlier also so many times I have repeated, lessee has to pay the lease rent because he got the right to use the asset which belongs to lessor. So lease rent covers the cost of using an asset. Okay, now for hire purchase we don't have a specific accounting standard. Okay, but for lease finance we have a specific accounting standard, that is accounting standard 19, okay, which used to explain how to maintain the books of account in case of your lease finance. Okay, next, in case of your hire purchase, sales tax paid by the buyer, paid by the buyer. But in case of lease finance, just we have seen in the last slide maybe, that it depends upon the actual value at the time of sale or in leasing. So three ways we had, you can again recheck your last slide, how the sales tax is applicable in case of lease finance on the leased asset. Three ways are available. One where the lessor is going to purchase the property with the resale certificate and make the lessee to go for tax. Another one we had, that lessor have the freedom, either lessor can pay the sales tax at the time of buying the property or buy the property with the resale certificate and make the lessee to bear the sales tax. Okay, so various three you can check in your last slide. But in case of your hire purchase, sales tax paid by the buyer only. Okay, then the next, in case of hire purchase, the hirer or the buyer is the owner of the asset and even same time user of that particular asset. Okay, okay? So when you are only the owner and user both, that means you have to go or take the responsibility of repairs and maintenance. But in case of lease finance, remember the difference between the financial and operating lease. In case of financial lease, lessee used to bear the maintenance charges. In case of your operating lease, lessor used to bear the maintenance charges. So what does it mean? Repair and maintenance depend upon the type of lease. Which type of lease contract you are entering, according to that it will get decided which party will bear the repair and maintenance cost. But in case of your hire purchase, buyer has to bear it. Okay, so this is all for the day, where we have checked the tax aspect, sales aspect, and the difference between hire purchase and lease finance. So for the day, thank you. Have a nice day. Okay, enjoy.